Welcome to part one of the STwrench tutorial series. In this video, we will be going over purchasing an STwrench and all the components you need to get started. Since the STwrench is a modular system, you get to pick and choose exactly what parts you want for your production or quality needs. The core of the STwrench platform is the controller. This is the brain of the system. We have the BI model, which has a removable battery located inside the handle. Along with the battery, you will also need a charger. Inside the back of the controller are ports for adding in wireless modules, a quality or production RBU to unlock more strategies, and a spot for adding a barcode scanning module to increase functionality. The next component you will need is a smartHEAD. These heavy-duty carbon fiber components come in a torque range of 15 to 1000 Nm and feature a quick disconnect and memory chip built in. The max torque of each head is clearly printed on the neck for quick reference when switching them out. Optional angle reading models feature a gyroscope. The final component you will need is an end fitting tool. These come in various sizes and types to fit the need of any job, and some come with an Atlas Copco tag solution, which can automatically select the P-set when the wrench recognizes a tool change. Once we have gathered all of our parts, it's time to put the STwrench together. In front of us, we have our STwrench Controller BI model, rechargeable lithium ion battery and charger, QAT barcode scanner, production RBU, QAT IRC Bluetooth module, 80 Nm smartHEAD, and standard 3/4 inch ratchet head. Let's start by assembling the controller. Using a 2mm Allen key, we can remove the two screws on the rear of the controller and remove the back plate. We now see three positions to add in our modules and RBU. I'll start first with the barcode scanner. Line up the holes on the barcode scanner with the screw posts and gently seat the module into position, careful not to touch the electrical contacts on the rear. Once seated, use a 2.5mm Allen key to screw it down until the module is snug in place. Now we will take our wireless Bluetooth module, or Wi-Fi module if you have that one instead. You'll notice the wireless module is not the same as the RBU, and the plastic tabs that are on the back are mirrored. Because of this, the wireless module can only fit into the far right slot. Remove the hand screws from the screw post and gently place the wireless module into position. Again, being careful not to touch the electrical contacts on the rear. Once the module is in position, you can gently secure them using your fingers to turn the screws. We will repeat the same process for our production RBU, and then close up the controller when finished. Next, we will unscrew the base of our controller and line up the battery contacts. Then firmly insert the battery until it is in position and screw the cap back on. We now grab our smartHEAD and position it with the torque markings on the neck facing up. By sliding up the coupler, we can see the cutout grooves that match up with the protrusions on the end of the controller. With the controller face up, we will slide the smartHEAD into the opening, then bring down the coupler and twist it in a clockwise motion to connect it. This requires a bit of force, and you will hear a click when it locks in. The final step now is to take your end fitting tool and easily slide it into the end of the head until it clicks into place as well. It can be easily removed by holding the button on the head and pulling the tool away from the neck. Let's make sure everything works. Place the tool on a level surface and press the on button on the controller. It's important to not be holding the tool midair and moving it around if you have an angle reporting smartHEAD, as this will cause the gyroscope zero to fail. Once you are booted up, you are ready to go. Check out part 2 for how to set up a PSET and perform a tightening. Thank you for watching this tutorial. If you have any questions, please leave a comment below and be sure to subscribe for more product tutorials and updates from Flexible Assembly.